Question number two, figure 2.1 shows the thinking distance and the braking distance for a car driven at 100 kilometers per hour. Okay, the car has old smooth tires. Now, thinking distance is the distance covered when the driver sees a hazard or something because of which he has to apply brakes, and till he starts to apply the brakes. So during this period, he would be processing, his mind would be processing and taking a decision that he has to apply a brake. So the distance covered between seeing a hazard and applying the brakes is called the thinking distance of a driver. Then the braking distance is the distance when the brakes were applied until the car came to a halt or it stopped. So when you apply brakes, the braking distance starts, and till the moving object stops, the distance covered is called the braking distance. Calculate the total stopping distance for the car. Stopping distance is the sum of these two distances, the thinking distance and the braking distance. When we add these two distances, this becomes the total stopping distance for any moving object. So we would be adding 21 and 75, and it gives us the value of 96 meters. So the stopping distance for this moving object is 96 meters here. Right. The car is now fitted with new tires. So the tires have now been changed. At a speed greater than 100 kilometers, the total stopping distance is the same as in the previous part. Now, here the car was moving at a speed of 100 kilometers per hour. And with the newly fitted tires, the speed of greater than 100 kilometers per hour, the stopping distance remains the same. State and explain the effect that the increase in speed and the use of new tires. So these are the two factors. The speed has been increased and new tires are being used now, have on the thinking distance. What would be the effect of these two factors on the thinking distance? The effect would be that it is going to increase. And why it is going to increase? Because speed is faster, although the time would remain the same. The time in which the driver is going to make a decision and apply the brakes, starts to apply the brakes, is going to remain the same. But the thing which is going to be important here is that since he was moving at a faster speed, so the distance covered is going to increase here. The next part, state and explain the effect that increase in speed and the new tires have on the braking distance. Now, the braking distance in this case is going to decrease. And the reason for this is that the newly fitted tires, the new tires would have a larger friction. So we would say that force of friction would be larger. Old tires and the smooth tires do not offer much amount of resistance, and that is why the braking distance is lower in that case. But here we are going to experience larger force of friction, which would decrease the braking distance here.